Hi there. In this demonstration, we're going to see how to conduct a hypothesis test for a difference in two means using Minitab. Specifically, in this case, it's with respect to independent data. In other words, it's not paired. Okay, and specifically also in this particular example, we're going to be using raw data. We're not going to be inputting summarized data, right? So we're going to speak about this in the context of example 1 from chapter 9.2. Right? So in this example, we have the cholesterol levels from 10 men who did not take a particular drug, right? And then the cholesterol levels from 10 different men, right? It's not paired, it's not a before or after. These are 10 different men who actually took the drug, right? And we're going to test the claim that the population mean from the men who took no drug is greater than the population mean for the men who took the drug. In other words, that difference, no drug versus drug, is greater than zero, right? Based on this sample data. Okay, so we're going to do this with Minitab. And the way we do that is we follow this brief sequence of events here. So I'm going to go over to Minitab. I'm going to press the stat button, basic statistics, two sample t-test. All right. And right away I have some options. I can get summarized data, and that's if I know all the summarized data, which I actually do in this case, but usually wouldn't. And then you have your two raw data options. The both samples are in one column, or each sample is in its own. That's our case here, right? So in our case, our data looks like this. There's a column for no drug and a column for drug, right? And I've already put these in here, but suppose, you know, when you get here, that those will be blank. So in order to see your options of no drug, your column options over here, you need to have your cursor inside one of these boxes. So for sample one, that's going to be no drug. I select it with this button, and it pops up over there. Sample two, that's going to be the people, the men who took the drug. Hit the select button, right? And now I'm going to go to my options. This is stuff about a confidence interval that gets produced, but we're worried about the hypothesis test. Here, the hypothesized difference comes from the null hypothesis, and we're testing that the difference is actually greater than zero. So the hypothesized difference is zero. That's the hypothesized difference in the null hypothesis. The alternate hypothesis is that the difference is actually greater than zero, or greater than this value here. Over here, you do have an option to do a less than for a left tail test, or a not equal to for a two tail test. But we're doing a right tail test, where the difference is claimed to be greater than zero. So I click OK here, I click OK here, and I get my results. The first thing it spits out is some statistics for the two different samples. It gives us the sample size, mean, and standard deviation for the no drug users, and the same thing for the men who took the drug. And we also have some confidence interval stuff down here. We're worried about the t-test. We're testing that the difference is greater than zero. The test statistic is right here. It's 2.47. But most importantly to us is the p-value. The p-value in this case is 0.012. So depending on your significance level, you may or may not reject the null hypothesis. If we're working at the 0.05 significance level, then that's great. Our p-value is less than that, and we reject the null hypothesis. And we get to say that the sample data supports our claim that the mean for the no drug users is actually greater than the mean for the drug users in all men. Right? So pretty easy stuff. You just have to bring the data in the form of two columns and click the right buttons, and it spits out some stuff, but most importantly, the p-value. Right? Hypothesis test for the difference in two means with Minitab. Pretty easy. Bye now.